There's more? Yet another Democrat is caught in a scandal as shocking allegations surface. In the age of Donald Trump, few states have been more resistant than California. The uber-liberal state has tried to defy just about every policy of the president. Its hardline Democrats have passed their own laws and used judges to undermine Trump's work to make America great again. However, it looks like this liberal-run state has plenty of problems. Yet another liberal from California is losing his seat after shocking allegations have surfaced. Since Donald Trump entered the White House, it seems like the Democratic Party is all but falling apart. Their rage towards the new president has pushed them over the edge. They riot and protest every word he tweets. They are losing credibility among their liberal news outlets. Revelation after revelation is coming out about their corrupt behavior. Worse of all, some of the left's biggest supporters have been outed as sexual predators. Now yet another Democrat is facing the fire. A California state assemblyman has announced he will resign next year. Why? Because six women have come forward detailing his unacceptable behavior toward them. He grabbed me with one hand, grabbed my head and shoved his tongue into my mouth, one of the women, Sylvia Castillo, said. With his other hand, he put it up my dress. I put my hand down to stop him from trying to grab at my crotch. I don't know about you, but I can't believe any man thinks he can get away with this behavior. If I even look at a woman the wrong way, I feel guilty. Yet these feminists are groping women's body parts and shoving their tongues into their mouths. Why aren't they all in jail? I'll tell you why, because they all do it. The left has created a cabal that protects its own. Already liberals are defending Al Franken, despite groping a sleeping woman. Bocanegra was known to have behaved this way in the past. He was accused of sexual harassment way back in 2009. Why is he still serving? Only took 6 years, Raul. How many more women has he abused in his position since then? It's clear that the left has turned a blind eye to their own sexual predators. Because these men have the right kind of politics, they get a pass. If news were to spread of all the harassment, then they'd be all out of jobs. The only people serving in politics would be decent, family men and women who are above reproach, like Vice President Mike Pence, who is never alone with another woman. And, guess what? They'd all be conservative. The only question left to ask now is, how many more? How many more liberal men will be exposed for this kind of behavior? And, how long until America wakes up and stops supporting them come election time?